In this video, we are going to implement the debugger. With it, we can log info, warning critical, and to do messages to our console and log file. Go to Solution Explorer, right-click on the core folder, add new folder, debugger. Right-click, add new item, select header file and name it debug.hpp. Click add. Right-click again on debugger, add new item, this time click on C++ file and write down debug.cpp and click add. When we log something to our screen, we also need to get the current time. Click on the core, add new folder, time, add new item, header file, time, utils.hpp, add. And again, right click on time, add new item, this time select C++ file and write down time utils.cpp and click add. In this video we will work with files, so in our precompile header we need to include file system and fstream. Now let's create the time utils class. And this is the implementation of the function which returns us a string with the current time and date. Open the debug.hpp and let's create the class. We want to enable and disable the debugger whenever we want. In the debug.cpp we are going to include timeUtils because we need it. In the debug.cpp let's implement those methods. We enable it only if it's currently disabled. Every time when we enable it, we store the current time in our enableStartTime variable. Then we replace every single colon with minus because we are going to name a file with this string and the colon character is not accepted by the operating system. Now let's add 5 more functions. With info, we log an info message. With warn, we log a warning message. With crit, we log a critical message. I recommend you to use this one only when we want to crash your application. With todo, we log a todo message, and with log, we just print a simple message. The first parameter is the actual message, and within the second one, we can optionally send a string that specifies our current module we are in. Let's add another function, this one is private, will write for us the text in our console and file. And within the public area, we declare two booleans, which will let us decide if we want to write to console and file or not. In the debug.cpp, we implement info, warn, crit, and todo functions. They are very similar. The only difference is that here we write info, here warn, here crit, and here todo. The log is different. We don't get the module string here. And now let's implement the writeTextPrivate function. If the console writer is not disabled, we can print the message to our console. If the file writer is not disabled, then we declare an fstream object and build our file name. If we do not have a logs folder in our application root, then we create one. Now we need to open the file in the append mode, then write the text to it and close it. Now I want to create some helpful macros because when we work within a module, it's annoying to send every time the module name. Now go to the engine.cpp and include our debug header file. At the beginning of the start function, we want to enable it only if we are in debug mode. Now let's specify here that this is core.engine module and replace every cout with debug grid. Now open window.cpp and do the same. Now open the main.cpp, include the debugger and specify the module name. Replace this line of code with debug info. And now if we run it, we can see that our debugger works just as we expected. If we open the project folder, we can see that a logs folder was just created. Open it and see here our previous log. In the near future, we are going to extend this class to draw debug text, points, lines, rectangles, and circles in our window through the renderer. That's it! I hope you liked it and I'll see you in the next video where we are going to implement the Vertex Array class.